Hello and welcome to another quick edit video, this time with a stormy landscape image from the Lake of Constance in southern Germany. For this image I want to apply a very dramatic look with strong contrast, very bright highlights and a lot of glow. For the editing I will be using Adobe Photoshop with the Camera Raw Editor and probably also make use of the Nik Collection plugin. So let's start. First off, I think I need to crop this image differently. The top part isn't that interesting and I think this image would be a great panorama. So let's apply some cropping. I think something like this looks pretty nice. Then next, let's apply the lens corrections real quick. And then I'm starting with the camera profile and I want to switch to Adobe Landscape, I guess. This will just make the image slightly more saturated. And for the white balance, I'm going with cloudy, just to get some more warmth in those highlights in the back. Now, first off, let me drop the highlights and I'm increasing the shadows. Then to add some contrast, I'm increasing the whites by always keeping an eye on the histogram to not overexpose anything. That looks pretty good. And right away, let's also add some texture and clarity for a more detailed image. Okay, I think I also want to drop the vibrance in this case, just a bit. Then that's it for the basic adjustments. For this image, a lot of changes will come through the local adjustments. So let's start with the gradiated filters. And I'm starting from top to bottom. So you can see I have applied two gradiated filters for the sky and that's just because I want to make the sky a lot darker. So with the first one I'm simply dropping the exposure. That should be enough. Then let's continue with the second one. Again, I'm dropping the exposure. And I also want to slightly drop the temperature. Okay, this just gives the top part of this cloud a slight blue color cast, which looks really nice in my opinion. Now let's also bring down the whites slightly. And I want to bring up the clarity and bring down the texture all the way. So we have some less noise in there. I could also apply some noise reduction, I guess. Okay, nice. Now let's work on the foreground. Again, I want to make this slightly darker. In this case, I'm dropping the blacks. So the highlights of those waves are staying bright. Then let's add some texture and some clarity. And this looks pretty cool. Okay, I guess that's it for the gradiated filters. Now let's work on the radial filters. And I'm mainly using them on the bright line in the distance. I just want to make this area appear to be glowing a little bit. So for this one, let me drop the dehaze. Okay, and maybe slightly bring up the temperature. Nice. In this area, I want to have some heavy glow effect. So I'm going to push the blacks and I'm dropping the dehaze. Just a bit. All right. So that radial filter is basically the first layer of this glow effect. Now I'm using this second radial filter to apply a more heavy glow. In this case, I'm increasing the whites to make this area brighter. And then I'm decreasing the dehaze quite a bit to add this glow effect. And then to get some color in there, I also want to boost the temperature. And that looks pretty nice. Okay, nice. That's it for the local adjustments. Then we can do some color grading. In the color mixer, I'm boosting the blue saturation a bit. Okay, and then for the color grading, I'm going to work on the highlights, which I want to make slightly warmer. So let's go in this range. And this looks pretty good, I think. And that's already it for the color grading. Now I want to sharpen the image in the details tab. And now we can finish it in Photoshop. First off, let me duplicate this layer by hitting Ctrl J. And now let's clean up this picture a little bit. Therefore, I'm using the spot healing brush. And I just brush over things that are distracting, like sensor spots. Okay, that's much better. Now I think this looks good, so we can merge those two layers. Then I want to enhance the glow effect in the sky some more. So let's add a new layer and switch the blend mode to hard light. By pressing B, I am picking up the brush tool, and by holding down the Alt key and clicking in this area, I can pick up this color tone right there. Now before we paint in the glow, let's drop the opacity. Otherwise, this would be too strong. Now, with the soft big brush, I'm just painting in a few times right there. Okay, that should be enough. Again, I'm merging those two layers by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. Then I want to do some dodging on the waves in the foreground. Therefore, I'm creating a new layer. Again, for this part, I want to use the TK panel plugin, which just allows me to create luminosity masks very easily. And with those masks, I can just specifically target those highlights in the foreground. So on that new layer right there, I'm adding a layer mask. And then let's see, I just want to target the bright parts of the waves. So this luminosity mask seems to be working. So we have applied it on our new layer, and we need to switch the blending mode of it to overlay. Then with the brush tool, we're going to set the foreground color to white and then just paint over the clouds. But first, let me add some opacity back. All right, that looks really nice. Then let's merge those layers again. Then next, I want to check the Nick collection to do the final part of the editing. So let's go to Filter, Nick Collection, Color Effects Pro 4. In this case, I want to start with the polarization effect. Let's just turn up the strength a bit. You can see it will just make the blue tones a little darker and a little more colorful as well. So let's see. I think this looks good. Then let's add another filter right away. And now I try to make this bright part a little more colorful as well. For this reason, I'm using the skylight filter. Let's see. Going to turn up the strength a bit. Of course, right now this affects the whole image, which I don't want. So I'm just setting a control point over this part right here. Just like that. Now let's apply it like that. Still, I want to create a layer mask on this layer, and with the black brush, I'm just masking out the foreground so we don't get any weird color tones in here. And finally, I could add a gradient map adjustment layer just for some more color grading. First, of course, though, I need to switch the blending mode to soft light, and let's also drop the opacity of this adjustment layer. To actually make those colors look good, I'm clicking on this gradient. This part right there affects the shadows. So here I want to go with a cold blue color tone, just like that. And for the highlights, I try to aim for a warm orange-like color tone, just like that. Then finally, I want to make use of the layer mask of this gradient map. And with the black brush again, I'm just brushing out this pier on the left side. All right, and that's it for editing this stormy landscape image. I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.